The fire got away from the high level area over there, crossed into the settlement boundaries, and then it destroyed at least half of our land. And I'm saying half of our land, that's at least 7 townships on the northern part, destroyed 15 of our homes, and it destroyed our culture, our lifestyle. No water, no moose, no ducks, no hunting, no trapping. We'll not recover from that for 15 to 20 years. It won't be in my lifetime. And our people haven't seen this yet. When they come home, they're gonna cry when they see what happened to our settlement. Most people that travel through here have cried to see what our land destroyed. We lost timber. We lost everything.
Have you reached out to any levels of government for help?
Well, we've tried so far. I think they handle us different than they handle anybody else. You know, like, I know what they did in Slave Lake and Fort McMurray. Seen it on the news, like, they bought emergency housing in for them people. And the emergency funding. And, like, for us, so far we don't have any of that in place. So, are they going to treat us the same as they treat the rest of Albertans? It remains to be seen.
The Chuck Egg fire hit here, and it started rolling in, and we prayed and prayed hard it wouldn't hit all 3 homes, as well as all of our neighbors. When we initially heard it was coming into Paddle, all we could do was pray. During this fire, we lost our father-in-law to a massive heart attack, and I do believe it's in part to this fire, because he worried so much about all of us getting out and getting to safety. I also lost my great uncle to smoke inhalation. He went to Lacrete. He was evacuated from high level. They went into Lacrete to get supplies, and they found him dead in the parking lot. The northern area is suffering. It's not only our community, but high level, Beaver First Nation, Lacrete, Denethaw First Nation. It's hit every part of the northern area. There's not one part that has been untouched, not one life that hasn't been touched by this fire.